First, we learn how the line tracking works. After that, I'm going to explain the code and wiring, and then we will test our car to see if it tracks a line. Welcome to Arduino course by Robojax. This course is based on SunFounder 3-in-1 Arduino kit sold on Amazon. Everything that you learn in this course is included in this kit. The course comes with tons of components and projects, all with instruction and video for smart car and other projects that you can use for school or home automation. You can purchase it from sunfounder.com. The kit also comes with full documentation, code download, learning projects with full explanation, wiring diagram, and the code that you can download. The link to purchase the kit and documentation is below the video in the description. This lesson is about line tracking. We are using this line tracking module, which has this infrared transmitter and receiver, and we have an operational amplifier that the intensity of the received signal will be adjusted using this variable resistor or potentiometer, and the output signal is read via this one of the pin. This can operate with 5 volts, and we are connecting it. This infrared sensor is called TCR-T500, and we have LM393 comparator or operational amplifier inside it, and here is a data sheet for that. It can detect the distance between 1 to 8 millimeter, and focal length is 2.5 millimeters. It can operate from 3.3 to 5 volts. And here is a project. If you go to the project, is 3.4 learning project 3 and then 3.4, and the module is made, the wiring is like this. Ground is connected to ground, V plus, the middle wire is 5 volts, and then the S or signal is connected to pin 2. And as you can see, signal is to pin 2, ground is to ground, and a middle, which is 5 volts, will be connected to 5 volts. I've printed this sheet with these lines to practice. The line is around 88 millimeters, and it can be up to 1.25 or 12.5 millimeters. So this is like 8 millimeters, and we are going to run this over the line. So how it works is, if we are able to see one value on the white area and other value on the black, then we have been able to detect this. On the car, on the smart car, we will have a little space, very little. If I put a screwdriver, this much space would be between ground and the sensor. So we have very little space, and when you adjust it, if you see, if I bring my hand, you see the light is turning on and then turn off. So that means that adjustment is relatively correct. Then we will rotate this to fine tune it, and we will adjust it. The best value that I got was in here. So remember this, this is not straight, like around 10 degrees or 15 degrees. This line looks like that. So we are going to test it and read the value. And here is the actual wiring. The left pin is connected using orange wire to ground. The middle pin is connected using yellow wire to 5 volts. And the right pin is signal, which is connected to pin 2. Now let's open the project 3.4. Go to File, Open, where you save the SunFounder file, 3-in-1 kit main, learning project, and scroll down until you see 3.4 line, detect the line, open that folder and click and open it. So we have defined pin 2 as a grayscale pin. That is where the signal comes from the line tracker. This is just defining the serial monitor inside the setup with 9600 baud, and we are getting that pin here using pin mode. We are defining it as an input. And then inside the loop, we are using digital read, reading that pin 2. The result, which is 0 or 1, is printed on the serial monitor, and we have 10 milliseconds. The loop will continuously read, either it will print 0 or print 1. Let me open the serial monitor here. We are reading 1. Now this is just reading 1. If the object is there, we will see some reflection. So this is not receiving any reflection. This is as if it's on black line. As soon as I turn it around, you see we are getting 0. And we have, now I'm going to pass the pin from here so you know how much we are. I'm not too far. I'm just barely touching the pin. Now let me see, and then I'm bringing it on black. As soon as I bring it on the black, you see we are reading the value. We are reading 0. Now I'm slowly bringing this on the line. As soon as I bring it, you will see that we are reading 1. Now this is on the line. Exactly, this is the point. And then as soon as I go here, it will be 0, and then 1, and 0. So we can detect the line. Now this is a little thicker line. It's 100 pixel wide. And let's see here. Now, let me pass the pen so you know. You know, when I pass the pen, it's 0. It's reading. So let me bring it. And here, 0. So if you are able to move this and then read the value, either 0, 1 on the line, and then 0 outside. 1 on the line, and then 0 outside, then you're ready for the next project. And here, to understand it better, this black is our line, and this is the position of our sensor. If the sensor is on the black area, then we see we read, well, 1, 0, and we move left. So the car moves left, and it reaches in the white area, and then as it reads white is 0, and it says move to the right. And it reads black here, so black is equal 1, so it says 1, then it says move left. And in here now it reads white equal 0, then it moves to the right. So this way it just moves left, right with 0 and 1, 0 and 1, and it stays on the line. This is the page for the project. If you go to the SunFounder documentation page, Car Projects, then go to number 4, follow the line. This is the page where they have explained everything, including the wiring, what is needed, and then the adjustment. And after that, there is a code. And after that, it has been explained. And here is the line that I've used. I'm using a ruler here to show you. It's exactly 25 millimeter or 2.5 centimeter for this test. Now let's open the project, click on file, open, go to the folder where you downloaded 3-in-1 kit main, and inside it car project, and then number 4, follow the line, select the file and click open. Here is the code. This portion is exactly the same as before. This is for motor, and the line track is connected to pin 2. We are defining this variable for the line input, and then setup. This is initializing the serial monitor, and these four lines are for defining pins as an output for the motor. This is for motor 1, and these two are for motor 2, just to remind you. And this line is to define the line track as input so we can read it. Now inside the loop, we are defining this speed as 150. Remember, the value is between 0 to 255. And then we use digital read and then read the line track. And when it detects white area, it will be 0. When it detects black, that's 1. So that's very important. Like I explained it before, the value will be stored here. And then I've added this line so this can print a. So this is like holding 0 or 1, and then we are printing it using serial monitor. And then here we check with using conditional statement if line color is this means if it is true or it is 1, then move left. So it's just by random selection we are going to the left. We could go also to the right, but here we just go to the left with the speed that we define here. Else, it means otherwise, it's white area, then go to the right. So it moves left, right, left, right, and this way the car stays on the black line. And here is this function controls the car to turn left, so the right motor is rotating and the left motor just stops, so it turns left. And when we want it to turn to the right is stopped, the left is rotating forward, so the car moves to the right. And here is a demonstration. I've put the sensor directly on this black line, and you see it says black, and the car is sending command for the car to go to the left. Now, because I've disconnected the motors, it's not moving. Let me just move it manually. As soon as I go to the left, it detects white and it says go to the right. Now our vehicle is there, it says it goes to the black, again it says go to the left, and like that, white, black, white, black, and as a result the car stays on the line. And here is the wiring. I've connected orange, red, brown. Brown is the ground, as you can see, it is connected to G. Red is V, it's connected to 5 volts. And then S, this will be connected to pin 2. If I turn this here, as we saw in the previous lessons, the red is connected to the positive. This is my positive, which is connected to this 5 volts. And this is my negative, which is connected using this blue wire to the ground. So the brown wire from the sensor is connected here. So these two wires, and so the orange is connected to pin 2. Okay, I've created this black path, and here is our robot. Let's see if it follows the line. So first I'm gonna put it on the line. As you can see, this is the sensor, and the sensor must be on the line first when you're initiating it. So let me connect the power and let's see. As you can see, the first circle completed, and it can do it.